This is Matt Russell, and welcome to the Daily FX Forum.
So here are the five pairs that I will be discussing this evening: the Euro Pound, the Aussie Kiwi, the Pound Swiss, the Euro Swiss, as well as the Euro Aussie. So let's go ahead and pull up the charts. The first chart is the Euro Pound. If you recall, two reports back, I mentioned the short trade for more aggressive traders at 90.15 with a stop at 90.30. I mentioned during yesterday's report that if you did enter that trade, to move your stop down to 90.15 and to stay in the trade. We did, the pair did sell off a little bit more, and I'm going to go ahead and exit this trade right now at 89.10. So take the 105 pips on the Euro Pound in profit. And moving forward now, again, as I mentioned, I do expect an eventual downside breakout, but we might have a little more consolidation here. So moving forward now, I actually like long trades against this longer term support line and this price point here. If prices do come down, let's call it 88.90, entry long at 88.90 with a stop at 88.60. So again, that would be long 88.90 with a stop at 88.60. The next chart is the Aussie Kiwi, and not much has changed here. Again, yesterday I missed that evening star reversal pattern by about 11 pips. So moving forward now, I do like the potential for a head and shoulder pattern here to form against the highs near the 25.50 area. So moving forward now, I might like an entry short at 125.45 with a stop above this high over here, which would be the 126 figure. So again, that would be short 125.45 with a stop at 126. The next chart is the Pound Swiss, and as I mentioned during yesterday's report, to exit all trades that were initiated at 63.70, to exit at 64.60 for a 90 pip gain. And we can see that prices actually did rally a lot more, and again, that's just part of trading. You know, you miss some profits there, but the Euro Pound has been acting as the inverse of the Pound Swiss, so hopefully you were able to make some gains in the Euro Pound, and the pip cost in the Euro Pound is more than the Pound Swiss, so it all evens out in the end. Anyway, moving forward now, I really don't see anything favorable setting up any clear support or resistance level, so I'm just going to stay on the sidelines. The next chart, and enter with the Euro Pound instead. The next chart is the Euro Swiss, and you should still be in this trade for the past two reports. The first entry was 147.46 with a stop at 147.20. During yesterday's report, the entry was 147.50 with a stop at 147.20 as well. So moving forward now, I still like this trade on the long side, and things are moving a little bit slow here. Obviously, the volatility has been very light in the pair, and actually moving forward now, I might look to take profits if prices do come up and test that 148 figure again. So I'd go ahead and place a limit at 148 even to take profits on this long trade. The next chart is the Euro Aussie, and not much has changed here. As I mentioned during yesterday's report, I am expecting prices to eventually come back and test the previous lows over here, which or the previous support level, which might now act as support, and that was an entry short at 159.25 with a stop at the figure at 160. And as I mentioned during yesterday's report, you know, prices were rallying a little bit, and this could be an ABC for a correction for prices to move back up to that, into the 159s again. So moving forward now, and this would be again for aggressive traders, and this trade could be setting up within, it could certainly be within the next few minutes here, but prices coming down and testing the 61.8 Fibonacci retracement level, and that level right now is 56.21. So I really don't want to take a lot of risk here, because obviously the downtrend has been pretty severe. We can see all these candles here, the pair went straight down, but I do like the chances for a reversal near that 61.8. So right now the entry would be long 156.25 with a stop at 155.90. Again, that would be long 156.25 with a stop at 155.90, and in my opinion, it's worth the 35 pips of risk just in case prices do bounce off that 61.8 and then move towards the 159 area. Again, my name is Matt Russell. Thanks for listening, and please stay tuned for a preview of the Daily FX Forums. I want to take this opportunity to formally welcome you all to the Daily FX Forums. I want to go through the process of how I personally access the forums, and how maybe you at home, if you want to access the forums in the future, might do so. The first thing you would do is go to www.dailyfx.com, and that will bring up, obviously, dailyfx.com. And usually there on the upper right-hand corner, I'll go ahead and click on where it says forum, and that will bring up the first page of the forums. And this view, I personally don't use this view, but this view actually shows you the most recent posts on all the threads within the different sections and a little detail about those posts, so you can read through and see if there's something, you know, catches your interest. But personally, I go ahead and just click on forums and view them in the more traditional sense. Now, these are different threads within the forum. There's a section on education, such as Daily FX course instructor tips, which would be good for newer traders. And then for more advanced traders, and I just want to go ahead, you know, personally, the way I use the forums is I would go through the individual threads, just looking for trade ideas, maybe looking at charts, looking at certain lines that maybe I didn't put up on my chart, but another trader might have put up on their chart. I tend to, you know, shy away from using direct trade recommendations from other forum members, but it helps me to sort of even out my analysis, make sure that I'm seeing things, you know, with the right mind in terms of, you know, I might be missing stuff that other traders can see. And that's, you know, my personal way of using the forum. You know, every trader is going to be a little bit different in how they use it. So if you want to ask questions, if you want to become an active participant of the members, you would have to go ahead and register. So that's what I'm going to go through now, is the registration process. So assuming you're brand new to the forums, or maybe you've been here a few times and you're not really sure how it works, so I just want to walk through again the registration process. This would be the front page where you would access, or the previous page. You'd have the same little box here on the left-hand side. My username and password are already filled out here, but assuming you're a new member, you would click on where it says register, and that will bring up the registration page. If you give me one moment here while my browser loads. And actually, first we're going to have some terms of service and Daily FX forum rules. I do suggest reading through the forum rules. Obviously, you know, profanity and spam and things like that are not allowed, but it also gives you insight on, you know, how to use the forum and how different traders can use it, you know, in terms of their individual needs. So you would go down to the bottom there, you'd click on where it says I have read all the rules, and then you would go ahead to the register, the formal registration page, and that will bring up here. And you can go ahead and select the username, and how about we'll use 4X, and that name is already in use, so maybe add a few more X's there. Again, it really, you know, your individual username is up to you, and you go ahead and fill in your password, your email address. Now, the most difficult aspect of registration for the Daily FX forums will be figuring out these letters in the box here. Now, I'm a semi-intelligent person, but I have a very difficult time figuring out which letters and numbers to use. Now, there is a reason for this madness. It helps with security, but I would suggest just going ahead and keep on clicking that refresh image until something comes through that you can actually identify and see. Then you can go ahead and enter your birthday, but you can decide whether or not to display that to other forum members. And then also, if you were referred by somebody, you can enter that information there. The time zone, that should default to your computer, but you should, you know, double check and make sure. And then you can opt in, and I would, you know, suggest opting in for these emails in terms if the administrators want to go ahead and send you some notices about the forum. And then you would complete registration. Now what happens is they would send you an email to the email address that you put up here, and that email will include a link, and all you would have to do is go ahead and click on that link, and that link will bring you inside the forum, and you would now be a member of the Daily FX forums. Again, this is Matt Russell. Thanks for listening.